So this is me weeding the garden in my village in Latvia. This picture was taken in the mid-1990s. And when the Soviet Union collapsed in the early 90s, it took with it the economy and thus jobs and income. Luckily, most people had access to land or had family that was able to grow crops and share them. So we grew all our fruits and vegetables, which meant that I spent my summers working in the garden. And at age 11, that really wasn't my favorite thing to do. But I did enjoy some things. I was fascinated by how seeds grow to become plants when put in soil. And I loved the smell of freshly plowed soil. So here I am today, willingly digging through soil in my attempt to understand it. When I arrived to the US, I was surprised when people called my study object dirt. I mean, dirt? Yeah, this word has a very disdainful connotation, something to describe a nuisance. But I understand where it comes from. When we look at a landscape, we normally see the mountains, the rivers, and the trees. We never notice the soil. We only notice it when it bothers us. In the early 16th century, Leonardo da Vinci said that we know more about the movement of celestial bodies than about the soil underfoot. Interestingly, this is as true today as it was back then, and maybe it is one of the reasons why we perceive our soil as dirt. Our ancestors did know some things about soil. They knew that when decomposing organic matter is put into soil in the form of compost or manure, it can help us grow more food and fodder for us, the manure producers. So they realized there's a cycle. But the true complexity of soil was hidden from us for a very long time. Only with the advancement of technology were we able to see these tiny soil minerals. And it turned out that these tiny structures have a huge impact on our soils. When these tiny minerals mix with organic matter, they create this vast and diverse environment that provides food, water, and habitat for microorganisms like bacteria and fungi. These bacteria, fungi, and the dead organic matter, in turn, are like pastures that can be grazed by plant eaters. Fungi are actually considered some of the world's largest organisms, meaning there's quite a lot to graze on. And then, of course, these plant eaters, in turn, can be preyed upon by predators both within soil and above ground. And eventually, all of these creatures die and return to soil to provide life and energy to the next generation. Through soil, plants become animals and animals become plants. So when we think about our previous life, we probably weren't noble lords and great philosophers. We were earthworms, potatoes, and fungi, just to mention a few. Soil is a complex system. It is more than the sum of its parts. Soils are defined by the interactions of the non-living, the living, and the dead. The boundaries within are always in motion. The living spread and retreat, they die and are reborn through the cycling of their atoms and molecules. When these creatures, processes, and interactions are in a balance, they create healthy soils that purify our water, grow our plants, and just allow this natural beauty to exist. However, within the last century, a third of our most fertile soils have been degraded due to chemical-heavy farming techniques, deforestation, global warming, and maybe due to our perception that it is just dead dirt. And this degradation occurs at our doorsteps. Here in the US, soil minerals and nutrients are eroded from land where they are needed to grow our plants and are washed into aquatic systems where they cause major algal blooms and dead zones. When we look around and we think that dirt is everywhere, we are right, dirt is everywhere. But healthy soil isn't. Soil is the skin of the earth, and currently it is getting thinner and weaker. When I was 11, I was clueless about the world underfoot. To me, it was earth, the stuff that miraculously made plants grow. But now, after studying it for 4 years, I realize it is much, much more. It is a world of its own. One day, I will be laid into soil to give back what I have taken throughout my life. And a new cycle will start, giving life and energy to the next generation. As it says in a very famous book, of earth they were made, and into the earth they would return together. When we perceive our soil as dirt, we are bound to disrupt the cycles of life and cause harm to ourselves. So let's just stop treating it as dirt. Thank you.